Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to another broadcast of Wealth and Wisdom with Fred Belcastro from the John DeVita Broadcast Center on the Windy City Hometown Entertainment Network and Jack FM 89.7 WRHS FM Norwich on Friday, the 29th day of January, the year of our Lord 2016. And now, here he is, Mr. Fred Belcastro.
When you're smiling,
and the whole world smiles with you.
And when you're laughing,
when the sun comes shining through.
When you're crying,
you bring on the rain.
Stop your sighing.
Won't you be happy again?
When you're smiling.
Keep on smiling.
Good morning and welcome to the Wealth and Wisdom program. My name is Fred Belcastro, your host. And during the next 30 minutes, we'll talk about using our wisdom, common sense, that helps grow and protect our wealth. And those of you who have listening for the past few years know that once again we're broadcasting from the John DeVita Broadcast Center here on the northwest side of Chicago. And of course you're listening to us on Jack FM 89.7 WRHS out of Norwich. Today, as usual, we're going to talk about using a bit of common sense, using a little bit of wisdom to grow and protect our money. Because the philosophy that I've had for the last 15 years is that there's more money to be gained by eliminating the losses than there is in trying to pick the winners. Everybody wants the winners, but so few of us give any attention to the 60 to 65% of our gross annual income that we're losing both through taxes and debt expenses. But coming up to the time of retirement, and that's what we'll talk a little bit about today, and our focus will be on age 50, age 55. These are the things that have to be taken care of. They have to be addressed, looked at, maybe even discovered. We spoke, and this has been going on for a long time, we spoke about the basis or the foundation. Remember, I went over to the blackboard and we drew this silly stick house, and we had the block that we labeled the foundation of this building, foundation of our finances, and in there we put cash flow, and then we transfer that concept or ideas over to our retirement planning, and we say, let's take a look at what we already have, what's guaranteed, if we can choose to use that word, and what do we have to build the retirement structure on. And one of the things that many of you had was, of course, the Social Security. And so we've hammered away a little bit at Social Security. We've done a couple of shows. I've done a couple of workshops on Social Security. And the focus at that time was to say, folks, let's find out what's available to you. There's the file and suspend and suspension tactics that we can use. And when we reach that retirement age of 65, 66, 67, whatever that might be for your personal date of birth, and we'll see then where you are and what we have that's in place that we can build on. And then, whoops, there goes another rubber tree plant, as Mr. Sinatra talked about. The Budget Act of 2015 changed and eliminated and restructured some of those benefits. So I hope that I wasn't speaking to dead ears when I said, hey, these are the things to look at. And if you're approaching that age or if you're in that age, let's take advantage of some of these provisions because, and I know I've used this illustration, it could mean a difference of maybe $100,000 to $140,000 of additional income that's given to you in the form of monthly payments by using some of these procedures or structures. And those of you who listened, I'm sure will thank me. Those who didn't, say, gee, I wish I could. I wish I should. You see? So from this day forward, why don't we do some of the things that we know we should be doing, and take a look. We don't have to go very far. Eisenhower Library has maybe about 200 books on retirement planning. Some of those are just copies of previous books, I think. But we've got an individual that told me about his buckets of money that he has. He has his money in three buckets, and that's the plan he uses. Good, bad, indifferent. But at least there's a structure. At least there's a concept. At least there's an idea of what he has. You know, we've been, for the last 30 years, since the mid or later 70s, talking about this great, great provision that's been made available to by our government called the IRAs, and consequently the 401ks through our employment and simplified pensions and things of this nature. But none of those are true pensions. You see, we have what we've called, or what brokers or advisors have called, nest eggs. This is my nest egg, and I have a 401k nest egg. But hey, my friends, I'm going to tell my client, there comes a time in life you've got to break that egg. Take a look and see what it really involved. What is it that you have in that nest egg? Do you have a pension? Do you have some guaranteed income that's going to last you and your family the rest of your lives? Or do you just have a tax-sheltered savings plan that's volatile, that's at risk? We talked about the difference between saving and the difference about investing. Is there a difference? You as Sarah Palin would say, you betcha. Well, anyway, the buckets of money concepts and the Paul Gravgard concepts, at least there's some form of structure that we would use. So I've said some of the structures that we can talk about. Income withdrawals. We used to do this years ago. And as long as I'm talking about years ago, let me talk about MLIP. When I started in the advisory business, financial service, I started with an insurance company, a local insurance company, Metropolitan Life Insurance, and we had what was called a MLIP, or My Life Insurance Program. In those days, what we did, when there was a policies in force for a family, you did what was called a structured programmed, or just plain, you'd program their insurance amounts. In other words, if they had $50,000, $100,000 of insurance, you would match that up with the needs of the family. By that I mean, if the breadwinner passed away, there'd be a certain amount of income that would be given to the widow and the children, if there were children, from Social Security, and that might be $600 or $800 a month at that time. And if they required an additional $200 a month, then $200 a month from the insurance policies would have to take care of that shortfall. At the end of the youngest child reaches the age of 18 at that time, the money stopped, and then continued once the wife or the spouse reached their age of retirement, and then they were given a spousal income. Things have changed now with two earners in a home and things of that nature. But nevertheless, then you would structure the insurance to take care of the time or the period for the widow from the time that the youngest child reached age 18 until she was able to qualify for her retirement benefits, and then you would continue that on. If you have an insurance policy and you keep them in a drawer or somewhere around the house, that's another thing too. You don't need to put them in a safety deposit box. They're no good to anybody else other than the owner of the insurance contract. So, but nevertheless, if you have the thing handy, you'd pull it out. And when was the last time you looked at the life insurance policy? Well, most of us don't read it. After you get it, you put it away and you don't look at it again until the time of need. But nevertheless, if you look at the back pages, there's what they call settlement options, and these are the things that you would use to allocate the amount of money that's necessary. You see what I'm getting to? This is something we did over 50 years ago, and it went out of style. It went out of fashion, because then the trusts came in, and that was the more sophisticated way. And of course, we all want to be sophisticated. We all want to be very knowledgeable. So anything that comes down the road that gives us more flexibility or more sophistication, we latched onto. So the settlement options programming method went out of style, as you might say. But nevertheless, if we were to look at that, there was the first one was interest. You leave the principal on hand and just collect the interest monthly, quarterly, semi-annually, annually, what have you. And then there was another option. You'll see it in your policy that you could take installment payments for a fixed period of time. I think the number two was a fixed amount. So if you needed $100 a month for the next 20 years, they would calculate that, and you'd put that in place, and then you'd have a 30-year span that you had to fill, and you would use, what I'm saying is the structure. You would look at, this was programmed to provide the amount of money. This is what you knew you had. If you passed away, you knew your family had this amount of money. This is amount from Social Security. This is the amount in survivorship benefits, children benefits. You knew. And then, of course, you'd have a life income, an opportunity for your widow or your spouse to take a life income at some point in the future. There was various settlement options, and you programmed. Remember, this was 50 years ago. You programmed it. Today, we've gotten away from the programming. So I talk to people and I say, how much are you going to have from Social Security? Yeah, that nest egg, if you cracked it open, it's not a pension plan any longer. We confuse the 401ks with my pension or my savings for retirement. It's an investment, and most of the time it's in flexible or volatile mutual funds. It's no longer a pension. All it is a savings plan. But nevertheless, do we structure that like we did 50 years ago? Do we structure or take the time to do that today with our retirement? Several weeks ago, I said, sit down and take a look at your budget. You have to determine what your fixed expenses are. From the time that you stop working, you get your gold watch. They don't give gold watches anymore. I used to tell people you'd get your gold watch and your pension check. And now you don't get a gold watch, you don't get a pension check. They might give you a cake, and that's it. You get a cake in a cafeteria and on a paper plate, and that goodbye. How sad. But nevertheless, from that time on, until the time of your expected longevity, how have you structured your money? You say, how have you structured? Do you know what rate of return? Here we go back to the basic four questions again. Do you know what rate of return you need for your dollars? How much more do you need to save or put away from now until that time of retirement? And if you don't have that, are you going to continue working to 66, 67, 68? Do you know how long you'll have to work? Do you want to work? Are you able to work? Are you in a position to work, health-wise, and vocation? You see, does your job allow you? Do you do some special talent that you could use or source, or do you have to reduce your standard of living? Program it. Come on, let's take a look and see what we can possibly do. Keeping in mind that we always want our dollars to be safe. We want the growth. We want the income. Remember, we talked about the liquidity and the tax benefits. Are we going to be able to just take systematic withdrawals from our money, which is really no system at all? We don't know. That's going to fluctuate. And if it weren't for taxes and inflation, we didn't have too many things to worry about. But if you take a look at what inflation is, and if you say, I'm going to live maybe the next 25 years after retirement, if we retire at 65, say 90 years old, which we talked about, at least one of us with a husband and wife or a spouse, an arrangement, is going to live to age 90, the income that we're going to require is going to pretty near double. Do we plan on that? Systematic withdrawal, or are we just going to willy-nilly just withdraw money from accounts until we run out? And then what are we going to do, live in our kids' basement or something? Then we could use dollar price erosion. We could just sell pieces of our 401k or IRAs, depending on the amount of money that we need. You see? Or are we just going to take out 3% a year? I have individuals that I've come across in my workshops that have said our retirement plan is that we're going to take 3% or 4% each and every year, and that's well and good. That worked back in the 90s. Up until about the mid-90s, 98, 99, you were able to do that. You would fix an amount, either 4 or 5%. But when you get, we haven't experienced then the big bangs that we've had, the cliffs that we've fallen over with the S&P. My God, 40% decrease pretty near in an S&P, an average. We're never going to make that up. We've done programs on that to show we're never going to recover. So you can't really any longer do a 3 or 4% withdraw. What I'm getting to is something that we have to talk about. Why don't we take a break now? I'll take a sip of coffee, and when I get back, we'll talk about what can be done. That was You Belong to Me by the Dupree's, taken from 1962. But whenever I hear that, I don't think of the Dupree's. I think about Tony Curtis and that movie, Six Bridges to Cross. That was the theme from that. I just threw that. That's extra. That wasn't on my notes or anything like that. But what is on my notes is a method to increase the retirement income you already have in place. Increase the amount of dollars that you might have available to you simply by using a program, a strategy that provides, I think, secure income over the your life expectancy. It's broken up into phases. I can tell you all about it. I can talk to you about buckets, and I can talk about the six phases it uses, how you set these in place, how you do arrange them. If you don't have anything that's in concrete now, that's not in stone right now, in the privacy of your own home, go to this website I'm going to give you. I'm going to give you a get a pencil because in the next few minutes I'm going to give you a website to view, to visit. Sit down in your own computer, take a look. You'll be educated. You'll see things that you haven't thought about over the last 10, 20, or 30 years. And if you have and you've done something about it, great. If not, this is education, strictly education. You ready for that website? All right, I'll give it a couple of times. I mentioned it last week, and I believe the week before. It's, you ready? F. Belcastro CFP. Now, the name is spelled FBELCASTROCFP dot IncomeForLifeModel.com. That's income, I-N-C-O-M-E, for FORLIFE-MODEL.com. Where that'll take you is to a website that I've subscribed to that gives you several movies, several structured workshops, a seminar for one, interactive tools that you could use. So I've talked about the four questions that you need to have answered, the rate of success that you need, the amount of dollars that you have to accumulate, how much longer you'll have to work. Here's a retirement income indicator that answers these four questions right in the privacy of your home. You don't have to call me. You don't have to get a 10-minute visual instruction from me. Just hit the line. You have something here with this tool that'll tell you how much income you can expect to receive from what you already have. And it'll also ask you a series of, I think, 13 questions that help you determine your rate of risk that you're willing to take with some of your dollars. You have an IRA? Should you roll it over into your 401 at work? Should you roll it over into an individual IRA that you have? Should you spend it? What dollars should you spend first? Do you watch a movie on that. That'll enlighten you and educate you. Do I have enough money to retire? Take a look. Only you know. Put the figures that you have available to you in. Wait. And when you put the figures in, nobody gets them. Nobody knows what you're doing. This is just for you alone. Nothing is sent online to anyone else as far as your figures are concerned. You would be able to talk to me in person if you wanted to. Just fill in the blanks and send it an email it to me, because on this website, my name, the phone number, and my office address is clearly visible. So you want to meet in person? Do you want to meet over the phone? That's fine. Do you want to request a personalized analysis? That's fine. If you don't click the button. Don't fill in the information. But on any of the interactive tools, they're for you. F. Belcastro CFP dot Income for Life Model. Use it. If you forget that number, give me a call. It's 630-673-4360. Have you ever thought about some of the things that you would need for long-term care? Do you want to see a film, a 10-minute film on long-term care and the various provisions that you could take advantage of with what you already have? Not anything additional, what you already have in place. Watch that. Take advantage of these things. Guaranteed income indicator. What amounts of dollars that you have that's providing a guaranteed income. Actually, what I am doing here is giving a tool where you can craft yourself with the guidance of a 20-minute seminar that's just for you. You're the only one watching it. If you have any questions, type them in. I'll get to them through through an email. But it shows how you can craft a financial strategy for your retirement. See, use the Income for Life model. And I'll tell you why you should use it, because it's the only one that's available to you where you can sit down and have all of your questions answered by watching films or viewing a seminar. Many of us know about the Kiplinger newsletters and customer service announcements that they make concerning finances. Kiplinger's letter talked about this very model, this income for life model, talking about how you can increase the amount of dollars that you already have available to you by just taking a few steps that may be suggested for you, using a strategy other than just withdrawing money on a needs basis that'll, of course, run out. Structure, program your retirement. That's very important. It's your retirement. F. Bell Castro, CFP, IncomeForLifeModel.com. What could be simpler than that? Program your retirement. In other words, change that nest egg into a pension. Pensionize your nest egg. You don't have a pension now. Do you want to sit down and talk about what you do, what you need? We can do that too. We can structure a time when you and I can either over the phone or in person talk about those things that are most on your mind. All right, let me have another sip of coffee, and then we'll finish up when we return.
Tonight you're mine completely. You give your love so sweetly. Tonight
How many of you recognize the Shirelles? That was from the early 60s, 1961 to be exact. Will You Still Love Me Tomorrow? Talk about remembering things. Remember that movie with George Clooney some time ago, The Perfect Storm? And so we've used that expression over and over again when we talk about the snow, the ice, wind, various conditions. But when you look at the perfect storm economically, for individuals at least, the nothing or low, next to nothing interest rates that we have, the stock market's going down, the worst January we've had in years, the fact that people are living longer and longer and not than ever before. These things that are occurring could create some stress for a lot of individuals, a lot of our seniors, as they try to look for ways to make their money last as long as they do. I think more than ever before. Look, retirements are dependent upon their retirement income. People have their investments to try to generate income because of fewer and fewer companies, almost non-existent today, other than municipalities and government, will provide a true pension plan, an amount of income that will last for as long as they do. So the individuals with these government-sponsored programs, and by the way, Obama wants to add to them a little bit too. You'll see some things in the future. But nevertheless, with fewer companies providing these pension plans, we're forced to assume the investment risk. We take the full investment risk, the full brunt of any losses with our nest eggs or with our investment or our retirement dollars. The reason I'm harping on that is because until now we've had no means, no method of programming, true programming, an allocation approach, you might say, that would be available to place sufficient emphasis, the emphasis that we need on both our income needs right now and the income that we're going to need in the future as retirees. The objective of the conversation that I've had with you this morning and the objective of the Income for Life model is to provide us with an inflation-adjusted income that could conceivably last us for the rest of our life. You talk about wealth and wisdom. Let's get smart about it and not leave it up to somebody else to tell us what we're going to be receiving and get that Social Security adjustment in the mail and saying, whoops, no inflation this year. Yeah, this is what you're going to get, and you swallow it whether you like it or not. All right, that's the end of our time for today. Thank you for listening. Listen, as the weather is getting warm, we expect some 40-degree temperatures. Let's get out and do something kind for one another and talk to you again next week. Thanks for listening. Thanks for supporting the station, and make somebody smile.
When you're smiling,
when you're smiling,
when you're smiling,
when you're smiling,
and the whole world smiles with you.
Smiles with you.
And when you're laughing,
when you're laughing,
oh, you're laughing,
oh, you're laughing,
when the sun comes shining through,
shining through.
When you're crying,
when you're crying,
you bring on the rain,
bring on the
stop
rain.
Your sighing,
stop your sighing.
Won't you be happy again?
Happy again.
When you're smiling,
when you're smiling,
keep on smiling,
keep on smiling.
And the world will smile.
You have been listening to Wealth and Wisdom with Fred Belcastro from the John DeVita Broadcast Center on Jack FM 89.7 WRHS FM Norge and the Windy City Hometown Entertainment Network on Friday, January the 29th, the year of our Lord, 2016. This broadcast was directed by John DeVita. Our special thanks to radio station manager Kevin Zeflik of WRHS-FM Norwich and the executive producer of Windy City Hometown Entertainment Network, Mr. John Secondo. Until next time, please be safe and thanks for listening. And this broadcast was pre-recorded on Wednesday, January the 27th, the year of our Lord, 2016. Have a good day, everyone.
When you're laughing,
and this is Jack FM 89.7 WRHS FM Norwich, a Ridgewood Community High School radio station. Have a great weekend, everyone, and thanks for being with us.